So we are at the alumni meet and we have these two pass outs are going to have a word regarding their experiences, the past and current, what they're doing. So yeah, please, thank you so much.
Yeah, hi. So my name is Saurabh Gupta. I graduated in 17th from Aerospace Engineering Department of IIT Bombay. And for all my life till now, I've done anything but aerospace. In my third year, I started my first company in solar and home automation with a budget of, you can say, 100 rupees from which I, purchased visiting cards and contacted all the solar companies, CEOs, and told them that I want to do some kind of partnership with you. I went to all the company CEOs, I talked to them, and then understood and got the entire idea of how the industry works and what are the things, you can offer. And after doing that, I started selling my consultancy services to other companies, to other small companies about solar and automation and all. So this is how my first startup of solar and automation consultancy started. And then I understood that if you want to start something, you just need to fill the gap which is there between any businesses or any systems which are there. So After solar and automation, there were some conflicts and all with my partner, and then I took an exit from there and I started exploring random industries. So I got into production, ad film production, advertising, and then there also I found that there is a huge void in the technology space in the media industry. So I got into gamification space, where I built a gamification platform that can actually make boring thing fun by using technology and gamified systems. So I did some interesting projects with multiple OTT platforms like Hotstar, Epicon, where I created engagement solution for television shows, engagement solution for various kind of boring products. So till now I have been pursuing the same path of building a world where things are not boring, things are fun, and it's been really good. Sometimes there were days like where you felt that why not do a job or leave everything, but suddenly things turn around and you are still continuing your journey. So startup is just like a roller coaster where there are good days, there are bad days, but the entire journey is very interesting, basically. And if you talk about what I have to say about the generation and the people in the startup scenario, so I think no time can be best than now to get into the startup space, because what China has achieved till now, India is going to be next 5 to 10 years. So this is the best time. This is the time when every other day there would be millionaires and billionaires coming out of all around India. So I think you just have to figure out the gap, the space where you can fill it, you can make it more efficient, more simpler, and just do that thing.
One word advice for the future Indiapreneurs 2020. That you feel that, yeah, that is going to take the country somewhere up.
I think one word advice I would say would be start. That's the simplest thing, because a lot of students I saw from my batch who were very creative, who had great ideas, but they didn't have the courage to start. So as a background, I did my BTech in computer science 2017 batch from the institute, and I started my company right after, or I would say from the college itself, fourth year. We are in enterprise technology space where we help very large enterprises like banks, insurance companies, mutual funds in increasing digital adoption. Okay. So today Reliance Jio has brought a smartphone and internet connection in every Indian's hand, right? Okay. This opens up a huge opportunity for people to acquire as well as to serve customers online. True. Everybody is on WhatsApp, everybody is on TikTok, everybody can now access Google Assistant, they can open up websites. So helping companies get a better digital adoption on these channels, that's what our solution is. And today we work with some of the major Indian brands, ICICI Bank, HDFC Bank, Kotak Mahindra Bank, SBI, ICICI Securities, Bajaj, like major BFSI brands. So like Saurabh mentioned, he started with a consultancy business. I believe that's a good balance between not starting and finding a product in one shot. that you start with something service oriented. We also started as a more of machine learning services company, wherein all the companies had a lot of data, but they couldn't do anything with it. How can I help them build solutions around that so that they unlock the power of data? Okay, that's how we started, and over time we got to learn the problem statements. We got to learn more core areas where these companies would pay better, right? And it creates more value rather. So that's how we started, and eventually we are getting towards the center, hitting the core. So my suggestion to youngsters would be to start with something. Like, don't think ki you will get a mega idea in one shot. Just start with whatever name solution you have in mind. It should add value, be it a service, be it not very scalable in the beginning, that's fine. But just start with something, because it's all an iterative process. It takes a lot of time to learn customer service, sales, marketing, HR, negotiation, hiring, firing. Nobody is born with these skills, right? But when you start with a service-oriented business, you learn a lot of it. You start building contacts, you understand the nuances, you get to know the problem statements. Later, when an idea hits you, you are all set for the mega expansion. So that's my suggestion. I mean, just start with something.
I think I totally agree with Aman. You know, so there is a lot of procrastination that we do, you know, while starting up things. So this is the first barrier, the biggest barrier which is there. Once you start something, once you, you know, invest yourself in some or the other way, either you invest all your saving or in some way you start doing things, then people, you know, things keep on happening automatically. But if you start things in a way like, you know, I will figure out the entire solution, I will figure out that what are the challenges I am going to face and how to solve it, then you are never going to start. So this is a problem, you know. Some of my friends have also faced a similar problem. Like they start working on an idea, they start, you know, conceptualizing it, they started asking to people, figuring out, then they stuck into some kind of problems, and then at that point they stop. Like then they feel that, you know, how should I go ahead from this ahead of this problem? I should try something else. So, and the second thing is that everyone who starts something or the other, na, they look for a $1 billion idea. They think I will start something, I will be a billionaire. So because of this thing, na, they never start anything, because I can say this, like, no $1 billion company has thought of on a single day, on the day, first day of their starting, that they are going to be a unicorn. Their idea eventually, you know, so this is the thing. I think this is the main thing, one of the core thing which I felt from my experience, from my colleagues, and you know, whoever I've met till now, that these two things, like, one is, you know, the entry barrier of starting up things, and the second thing is, you know, looking for a $1 billion idea. These two things, if you conquer, then you can start things.
Guys, write to tomorrow.